Oh boy, I think that's probably the best I'm gonna get it. What's going on, guys? Doing some Galaxian on the 5200. This is actually a really awesome game. I'll throw this up on the screen, maybe right now. But I actually got a technical world record for this the other day. Technical world record for MAME emulated. As far as I can tell, at least, based on the high scores that I've seen. Yeah, I got 20,125 points, which is 3K, I do believe, above the current world record. Damn. Yeah, I wanted that little welding tutorial video to be longer. I don't know. But then I was thinking about it, and I don't know if I want to combine the videos. I'm just going to go ahead and just leave it short, you know. I don't have any music playing for this one right here, so I'll just do my usual thing and throw on some relaxing Nintendo music or whatever. Yeah, this is a video game, my dude. This is a fucking video game. So, what makes this a little bit different from like Galaga? It's not quite as fast-paced. If I had to compare this, I can't remember if I've talked about this on a video before. I probably have. This game is like slow and steady wins the race, you know. Basically, you're dealing with a Roman phalanx pattern of enemies, which is typical for arcade space shooter arcade games of the time. But what separates a game like say Spider Fighter and this is the pace of it, and also the characteristic dancing of the enemies. You see how they kind of move and flow around like that. So yeah, that's very typical of a game like Moon Cresta that I was playing the other day. But this game, the pace of it is just, it's very sluggish, you know, obviously on purpose. And you can only fire one shot at a time. It's like the difference between Rambo and Dirty Harry. You know, you really gotta make your shot count. See, like right there, I didn't make my shot count. And you really gotta know the little differentiations and the patterns that happen when they start dancing around. By the way, I do apologize. You guys caught me mid-game. And that's another great thing, another great feature about this game, is that the 5200 was one of the first gaming consoles that had a pause button. I think the ColecoVision also had a pause button. If it did, I sure as hell didn't use it. Ooh, man. They're getting rough this time. Yeah. Sorry if I sound like I got the sniffles, because I do. Actually, I didn't even go into work today. Feeling a little under the weather. Not like there's really much to do anyway. Yesterday I was only able to make 175 parts. Which is, you know, which is absolutely bonkers to me. Because, like, they had the air compressor and the dryer running all night, ostensibly just so that they could make raw materials for me, but then they only had 175 prepped. Like, it doesn't make any freaking sense, man. Like, I don't get it. Oh, shit. Oh, they got my number that time. See what I'm saying when I say that it takes a long-ass time to build up a score? You gotta get those bonus points, man. You gotta get them 150s and the 200s and then 300s, baby. I wonder what qualifies those. Maybe the pattern, their little flying dancing pattern, has to be initiated first. And maybe a certain amount of enemies have to be on the screen. I don't know. Oh, man. Perhaps Penny can bring out her computer book and come up with an explanation. Cree Summer. I wonder what she's doing these days. Good old Cree Summer. She was the voice of Penny on Inspector Gadget. She was also the voice of Susie Carmichael on Rugrats. Man, the episodes with the Carmichaels were a lot of fun. It's because her dad was the inventor of the Dummy Bears, which was, I was supposed to be, I guess, like the Gummy Bears. Gummy Bears. Is that a Disney franchise? Can't remember. Woo! You see that? See that shit? See that shit, boy? I got skills to pay the bills. I got skills to pay the bills. I got the skills to pay the bills. Just like Mike D, baby. I got the skills to pay the bills. I got skills to pay the bills. Well, I'm Mike D coming at you with the program. Ooh, old Skinner family recipe. For steamed hams. Yes. Well, yeah, I should be. Good Lord, what's going on in there? Aurora Borealis? Aurora Borealis. At this time of the year, at this time of day, in this part of the country, localized entirely in your kitchen.
Yes.
May I see it?
No.
I must have watched that steamed hams. Oh shit! I must have watched that steamed hams video. The clips of Principal Skinner and the superintendent. I was watching that like all morning yesterday. Ah shit! 13,000. That ain't bad. 13,000. That's not the worst score I've ever gotten. Like I said, it takes a long time to build up a score in this game, though. Yeah, it's not like Galaga. very, very, very slow game. You know something? Sometimes you gotta chill back. You gotta ease back, just like Cool Keith used to say. Them Ultramagnetic MCs albums. You gotta ease back. You gotta break north and you gotta ease back, baby. Just like Cool Keith used to say. Ooh, yes. Patented Skinner Burgers. For steamed hams. Yes. That's gonna be like my new favorite thing for the next month. Steamed hams. Yes. Shit. Yeah, man, you gotta go for them bonus points, baby. The very least you can get points faster. Man, that's a chip. Tell you something else I was watching last night. I was watching some clips from the Yu Yu Hakusho movie. The old school one, before they made the Funimation dub. Back in the day, me and my friends used to rent that videotape. It was, like I said, this was before Adult Swim started airing it. And I know what you fucking retards on YouTube are gonna say, Yu Yu Hakusho wasn't on YouTube, it was on Toonami. No, it wasn't. It was on Adult Swim first, and then they moved it over to Toonami, which is what they should have done with Inuyasha instead of Yu Yu Hakusho. And they cut out way too much from Yu Yu Hakusho when they moved it over to Toonami. And it doesn't even make any sense, because I imagine that the Nielsen ratings and the average age of the audience, even though it was airing on Adult Swim, I imagine Adult Swim had a lot more people who were like 13, 14 years old within the Toonami, you know, age group range. I imagine Inuyasha had more people within that Toonami age group range watching it than Yu Yu Hakusho did, you know? You know, Yu Yu Hakusho was a very adult show. I mean, for what it was, I mean, it was about a bunch of middle schoolers fighting ghosts. It was a lot more adult than Bleach. Say that shit. Man, that show sucked. Like, the first two the Soul Society, like, once I got to the Soul Society arc, I was just in... I don't know, man. Like, one of the things about Bleach that, like, really pissed me off was the set designs all look the same. Oh, somebody's here.